Let's just set public policy on the whims of 16-year-olds, right? Well, no. Few things annoy me more than protests done in a disingenuous fashion or protests facilitated by people who couldn't care less about the, well, the promoted underlying reason for the protest. So was the case with this massive school walkout yesterday. They predicted a million students, or they estimated a million students had walked out of schools around the country. Some became very violent. We'll get into that in just a second. But what bothers me about these school protests isn't the promoted reason. Look, 17 people were killed in Parkland, Florida, only about 30 minutes, 20 minutes even, northwest of where I'm sitting right now as I bring you this show. Like I've told you previously, I had friends whose kids went to that school. I have friends in that area. I knew some of the first responders who showed up on scene. I went to the memorial on the school grounds. It's tragic. It's heartbreaking. You can't leave there with dry eyes. But that being said, these kids are being used as pawns. 1 million high schoolers didn't arbitrarily decide that they were going to walk out of school for 17 minutes and coordinate that across all 50 states. This was a well-coordinated, well-oiled, far-left effort. A far, far-left effort. Now, I don't want to ever, I don't want the United States of America to ever set public policy based on the whims of 16-year-olds. These are the same people who eat Tide Pods for fun. I'm not demeaning these kids. I'm not demeaning what they went through. But look, unpopular opinion from John Cardillo. A bunch of kids in a high school in New Mexico, no, they don't have an emotional connection to the kids over here in Parkland. They just don't. It sounds great, and they want to be social justice warriors of the day. But skipping school for 17 minutes doesn't all of a sudden make you an expert on domestic policy, firearms policy. It just simply does not. And this silly, I would even call it an idiotic effort by groups like Moms Demand in Every Town flies in the face of every fact. Look, I'm not going to go back into the Second Amendment debate. Now, there's a great graphic floating around the web today on Twitter, and I've double-checked this with international crime stats. The nation of Brazil actually has more homicides than all other developed nations combined. Well, I shouldn't say all other, but most of the developed Western nations combined. I believe the numbers in Brazil were 59,080. And the rest of the developed Western world was, I believe, 59,012. That's a significant problem. And on its face, debunks the gun debate. It debunks the need for gun control. But see, this isn't about gun control. This is about a tantrum from the left, from the far left, who are now using children as pawns and riding the back of a tragedy. When I went over to the Parkland Memorial on President's Day, and it was that was that Monday following the massacre, it's only 4 days later, I went over to the anti-gun, I've told you this on the show before, I went over to the anti-gun rally hosted by Moms Demand in Every Town about 5 minutes from the Stoneman Douglas campus. And the representatives from Moms Demand in Every Town, these two far-left anti-gun groups funded by Michael Bloomberg, they have a lot of money, they constantly just make up their own facts. And the woman who runs them, Shannon Watts, who was a communications guru over at Monsanto prior, she's not some organic mom who just decided one day she wanted to eradicate guns and enact gun control. No, she's a professional corporate communications person. Shannon Watts, for years, she blocked me about 4 years ago, for years, since she's come on the scene, has blocked anyone on social media who disagrees with her who presents actual facts. See, that's the left. They don't want healthy debate. They don't want open and honest discourse. They want to give you their version of events. And if the facts, if the FBI or the U.S. Census Bureau or the Center for Disease Control, you know, these little fringe organizations that nobody uses the FBI's data or CDC's or the U.S. Census Bureau, these little fringe organizations like FBI and CDC, well, their data doesn't comport with Shannon Watts and Moms Demand's home-generated data, then they don't want to hear it. They block you. They silence you. They won't engage you in debate. They smear you. They attack you. But now they've reached a new low using school kids as pawns. Now, predictably, this entire thing digressed into something else. Okay, kids walking out of school for 17 minutes. Okay, now, yes, symbolism. It looks nice, and let's all say, wow, we feel bad for these kids. They shouldn't have to go through this. But again, unpopular opinion. The kid in Nebraska has no emotional connection to the kid in Parkland, Florida. This was a little bit of grandstanding on the part of the anti-gun groups. I'm going to get flamed for it. It might be an unpopular opinion, but let's be honest about what it was. They wanted to walk out. They wanted to feel like they were nouveau 60s hippies, and we had a lot of conflicting information. As I read social media today, parents are saying, well, I was given very conflicting information. We were told by the school that this was a nonpartisan, non-political walkout just to honor. It was a memorial for the 17 minutes for the 17 people killed in Parkland, students and faculty. That would have been fine. But then kids are coming home saying, well, no, my teacher was reminiscing back to when they were a protester in the 60s, and they were saying how horrible conservatives are and how horrible gun rights are and how the Second Amendment is outdated, should be repealed. It's about muskets, all the usual talking points of the left. So I'm going to go much, much deeper into this and tell you some of the more negative things that happened, as well as the true, true motives of those who are behind this and the true motives of those who are funding this. And I'm going to do that for you on my longer show, my one-hour show, Off the Cuff Declassified today, right here on The Rebel. I want to keep bringing you this content every day because I love bringing it to you. So help me do that. Subscribe to our premium service at www.therebel.media/shows. Also, go to firescottisrael.com. I'm putting together a very interesting report, something you haven't heard that's going to blow your mind, on Broward County Sheriff Scott Israel. Sign our petition at firescottisrael.com. We'll deliver it to Florida Governor Rick Scott. We want him to remove Broward County Sheriff Scott Israel. He is incompetent. He does not deserve to be in that role any longer. Also, go to whatever device you have, the App Store. Go to whatever device you have's App Store. Download the Rebel app. Great way to get all of our content. If you've done any or all of those things, and I hope you do all of them, I like hanging out with you guys every day. Thank you very, very much. And as always, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you tomorrow.